You see here, this is the Doppler radar for the Texas area. So we'll monitor that throughout the day and into the evening for our night jock watch. That helps us kind of forecast what might be happening in Texas.
The Joint Operations Center runs 24/7, tracking all current crises from wildfires here in Washington State to the unprecedented flooding in Texas.
So it's kind of a balancing act of if we do have resources that Louisiana and Texas need, is it something we also need here? Because we don't want to release those to turn around and have to recall them back.
Colonel Kevin McMahon, Director of Operations with the Army National Guard, says right now a lot of aviation resources are being requested to help in the aftermath of Harvey. DOD says Air National Guard support has been sent from states including Alaska, California, Oregon, and New York. These are skilled pilots and teams trained to navigate the trickiest of hazards.
Obviously, they want to be aware of power lines. They want to be aware of any uptake that could go into the engines, which then could cause a catastrophic failure on the aircraft itself. So just a variety of things that they need to take into consideration.
A Washington's Guardsman trained for domestic disasters of all kinds, whether it's catastrophic flooding to the expected massive earthquake that has the Pacific Northwest on edge.
We would ask our soldiers and airmen to be resilient, and we'd ask the local population be resilient as well.
Colonel McMahon says that means having supplies to survive 4 days, ideally 2 weeks, and thinking through a family plan before disaster strikes.
If the floodwaters are 24 hours out, that's not the time to come up with that plan, and that's not the time to go get those resources. So having that all thought through, exercise that with your family, with your friends, that's, I think, the key to success.
A good reminder for everyone. As far as other local teams monitoring Texas right now, I've learned that a handful of King County employees plan to head to the state in coming weeks to help FEMA with ongoing recovery efforts.
Boy, such a need there.
All right, Natalie, thank you.